So I've got a question here. Yo, Harley, you have to be the loosest guy on YouTube. Keep it up. I would like you to share your comments and criticisms about Vince Del Monte. I spent about $1,000 doing all these programs. I did lose a bit of weight, but literally didn't crap for a week. And when I did, it was only rabbit pellets of pure protein from all the food, the whey protein, eggs, steak that Vince had me eating. When I resumed normal caloric intake, yes, I was in a starvation program, I absolutely ballooned out and kept gaining belly fat till I got on your program. I have been getting leaner and feeling the best ever. Thanks, mate. Have more energy to keep up with my kids, and my sex drive is also stronger than ever before. Can't argue with that. My T3, which is a thyroid hormone, and testosterone actually lowered during Vince's program. But when you're starving yourself and you're reducing your carbohydrates, your T3, your testosterone, that's why most bodybuilders out there in that sort of world doing T3 and they're doing tests, which is, I don't recommend. So his T3 and testosterone lowered on Vince's program. Could you please comment on this and Vince's latest video about vegetarians? I think Vince needs to hear some dirty truth so he doesn't mislead more people. Thanks, Troy, Nebraska. Nebraska, I've never been to Nebraska. Sounds a cool name though. All right, let's get stuck into a quick video. Vince Del Monte, who is this guy? Who is this guy? So first up, Vince Del Monte, or whatever. How to customize your own muscle building diet. Vince says here, your general goal should be to gain 1/2 pound to 2 pounds of muscle each week. Okay then, 1/2 pound to 2 pounds of muscle each week. So that's like, yeah, okay, interesting. And if you look down below, down right here, it says mass cycle, cut cycle, steroidclub.com, buy now, hardcore products, click here. So basically what we have here, now nothing personal against this Vince guy, sure he's a lovely guy, just share my comments and criticisms. What we have here is, in my opinion, someone who is talking a lot of spammy sort of content, like build 2 pounds of muscle per week. 2 pounds of muscle per, 110 pounds of muscle or whatever per year. So you can imagine anyone reading this stuff is going to go, oh, I'm going to buy that. If we go to Vince's website, it's just full of this gimmicky stuff, you know, just nonsense. And the metabolic damage that occurs when you follow these calorie restriction, low carb diets is horrendous. I want to keep this video quick and straight to the point. First up, let's have a look at Vince. This is the photo he uses to market his product. Now let's go to his most recent video about vegetarian bodybuilding. Now here's a picture of Vince. So that's May 6, 2013. Now it looks like Vince has either photoshopped his face onto someone else's body or he's gained a lot of fat. And there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that at all. My mum's obese clinically and I still love it. Just because you're fat or out of shape doesn't mean you're a bad person. This is merely a performance-based critique. Physical performance, that's all we're judging here, nothing else. Because if you, it's only fair game, if you go out there and say, hey, look at me, I'm lean, I'm ripped, then it's only fair game if people go, actually, you're not ripped. Have you looked in the mirror lately? So Vince, if you're watching, mate, you probably need to update the photos you're using on the internet. Here's a request, Vince, next video, show us your abs, buddy. Show us how lean you are. So what I look like is what I am. I don't put up misleading photographs. Same with Frilly. This is what we're like all year long. Slim, lean, fit, healthy, drug-free, full natty bra. So what I'm going to do now is quickly play back a few comments that Vince said in his video about vegans can't build muscle, vegans can't burn fat, etc. I'm going to throw you some little sound bites from Vince, and I'm going to have a rebuttal following that. So this is a bit of a debate, friendly debate. So again, nothing personal against Vince. You're out of shape, you're overweight, doesn't make you a bad person. I'm merely just sharing my comments and criticisms, not hating, just saying, let's get it going.
Question I've been avoiding for years, and that's, what are my thoughts on plant-based eating, being a vegetarian, being a vegan, in terms of, you know, in correlation to building muscle, improving your physique? And I know this is gonna upset a lot of people, but I refuse This has been since 2002, since I was a trainer. I refuse to work with anybody who is a plant-based eater if their goal is to build muscle, improve health, to do anything, period, to lose fat. To be honest, I feel like you're wasting my time. I feel like you're wasting your time, and I don't believe I can help you. That is probably the most, those are probably the strongest things I can say, but that's how I feel about the subject. We were clearly meant to be meat eaters. We evolved on an animal-based diet. Question I've been avoiding for years, and that's, what are my thoughts on plant-based eating, being a vegetarian, being a vegan, in terms of, you know, in correlation to building muscle, improving your physique? And I know this is going to upset a lot of people, but I refuse. This has been since 2002, since I was a trainer. I refuse to work with anybody who is a plant-based eater if their goal is to build muscle, improve health, to do anything, period, to lose fat. To be honest, I feel like you're wasting my time. I feel like you're wasting your time, and I don't believe I can help you. That is probably the most, those are probably the strongest things I can say, but that's how I feel about the subject. We were clearly meant to be meat eaters. We evolved on an animal-based diet.
I don't know, Vince. I'm not sure about the carb thing.
I'm gonna recommend you guys read a book from Lyra Keith. It's called The Vegetarian Myth. Probably the most mind-blowing book you'll ever read on the subject. She was a vegan for 20 years.
But as a vegan, no, you're gonna collapse. And the last study they did, actually surveying vegans and how often they cheated, once a week, vegans eat beef, which to me was a shock because I never cheated on beef, but I certainly binged on eggs and dairy every chance I got. And then, you know, you would...
Hey, so vegans are going to fall apart because they don't eat animals, but vegans also eat animals once a week. And Leah Keith said she was a vegan, but she says, I binged on eggs and dairy every chance I got.
I'm going to recommend you guys read a book from Lyra Keith. It's called The Vegetarian Myth. Probably the most mind-blowing book you'll ever read on the subject. She was a vegan for 20 years.
But I certainly binged on eggs and dairy every chance I got.
She was a vegan for 20 years.
But I certainly binged on eggs and dairy every chance I got.
Phenomenal book, which just blows apart every single argument that anybody's ever made for eating, following a plant-based diet, and why it's perhaps the most unhealthy thing you can do. I find that a lot of people who report, reasons for why they're feeling better off this diet, it's all in the head. I strongly believe that anybody who says they're eating vegetarian for health reasons is... that was a nice way to say it, is very misinformed. The only time insulin is released is from a body, it's literally like a survival mechanism. Your pancreas secretes insulin when there's glucose in the bloodstream and it says, holy crap, we need to get this out of the bloodstream. Oftentimes, people who eat these, you know, vegetarian diets, they replace them with high carbohydrate diets, and it just evokes a whole series of health problems. And for those who don't know, insulin provokes the growth of cancer cells. And for those who don't know, cancer was unknown to hunters and gatherers. Wilson. Cancer was unknown to the Eskimos. Wilson. Not just cancer, but heart disease, Wilson. Autoimmune disease, chronic degenerative diseases, diabetes. These things were all unknown.
Bullshit.
There's no reports. They never experienced this stuff. This stuff that we experience as normal, you hear about your friend who gets some sort of disease, you're like, oh yeah, it's normal. Yeah, it happens to people these days. It never happened decades ago. It never happened decades ago. This is all new. Check out this book by Lyra Keith, the vegetarian myth. I read it with an open mind. It's gonna shake a lot of people up. It's gonna probably challenge, if you're a plant-based eater, it's gonna challenge your beliefs, but it may save your life.